service caravan, etc. So I kind of explained to her, in my opinion, I understand the respect that you are expressing and stuff. And I did say, I remember seeing that Dr. Whitney had kind of sent out a notification that any parent or any guardian of the students, they were sure more than welcome for their children and kids to be part of the system. But as a school district, I didn't know exactly where we probably were standing totally on it. And she was asking something about dismissal of school. I have no, but I just thought this would be maybe an opportunity if Dr. Whitney or any other board members or anybody wanted to express some concern. It wasn't a complaint or anything like that. It was just a concern. So that's just what I wanted to make in the public comments.
I was told that that person that had a concern would try to be at the board meeting tonight to ask for us to reconsider what Dr. Whitney had put out, that all, if kids wanted to go to it and participate, they'd have to be checked out. She is requesting that the students in Hedo be able to use buses to go to Parmalee and hold up signs of respect, and they would get back to the school in time for busing.
Actually, that's already been arranged for third through eighth grade. We have a shortage of bus drivers, so we have one there in Hedo, one from downtown. So actually this afternoon, we learned that they would be there by two, because before when I talked to the Veterans Affairs Department, we were worried that they wouldn't even make it that far before the kids got dismissed from school. And since then, we've learned that they're going to stick to a really strict schedule, and they'll be there by two, so the students in third through eighth grade will be in Parkland to greet them. So I think any other students that want to participate, even though they're not probably
agenda. By Deb, second by Melissa. All in favor?
Yes.
Okay, we have some successes in the district. Dr. Whitney, do you want to address that?
Well, I guess the first one that would be noted would be the high school enrollment numbers are up almost about 100 students. Support staff at high school, 93.17%. certified staff at Longview, 94.50%. Support staff at Littleburg, 99.92%. Wow. Certified staff at Rosebud, 95.38%. Certified staff at middle school, 94.95%. And the support staff at the achievement school, 94.97%.
My name is Jen Hyde, and how is it being Native American? Well, being a Native American is from what I is. I grew up around white people, not in New England. I grew up in White River. I live in Cold Creek, and I have been friends that made my life more interesting. Lakota people are proud, Lakota people are spiritual, so life as a Native American is really interesting. I want to give a shout out to Lauren and David, who raised me to be who I am. And a shout out to Brooke Donnelly and Olivia Frederick. They showed me what manners are awesome, and a shout out to Gary Peake and Michelle.
I was blown away by Kaylee Wurdenheim. My great-grandfather, Chief Wurdenheim. I am a descendant from Wilza and Wayland Wurdenheim. I was raised with and without Lakota. My grandmother taught me to say and speak Lakota. What Native American Day means to me is remembering the brave and strong. Native Americans are strong, smart, and quick thinkers. Native Americans are themselves. Spiritually and physically, I go to Oak Creek School. I am proud to be a Native. I'd like to give a proud shout out to my mom, Wilza Wurdenheim, a strong, proud Lakota woman.
And there she is, where we're going with that.
My name is Akasha, where I go to Oak Creek School. I am light-skinned Lakota. Lakota come in all shapes, sizes, and colors. I am proud to be Lakota. We are strong. We are respectful. We are brave. Most of all, we stand as one. I would like to give a shout out to my grandpa. Kenny Grandpa has always taught me how to be a good citizen and a great Lakota. My grandpa is now the president of Oak Creek. Congratulations, Grandpa.
So that was our PSAs, and I
Honorable School Board, present to use a curriculum that's proved itself in the Lakota country. You see some of the data that shows that the use of the curriculum is what we need for our children. Our children are second language learners. They're second language learners that come to us and they're fluent English speakers. And the curriculum that the Lakota Language Consortium has and provides is relevant to the generation that we're serving today. With the work that the Language Consortium had put together, present themselves with confidence, because we know that with education, self-concept is very important in pursuing. I'm wondering if you want to consider this also. And we searched for language curriculum that was that showed competence, but also showed that in ELA, we want to look for something that just doesn't do direct instruction. We want to look at something that has kinesthetics and auditory and visual. And then we also had taken a position as the fellow who saw my educator that would be able to deliver this curriculum. Wow. And if you look at that data there, he wanted me to point out to you that since he was teaching at St. Joe's, he really shot up way over there. So, and that's Mr. Alan Wilson here. He came home, he brought it home to come pop us out. But he's very dedicated, he's well trained in universities. And I sat and visited with Roosevelt Education Department and many others that I considered my mentors on Roosevelt. And we want to move forward, we want to use the material. We see that we've been complacent for so long, stuck on bottom and right, and in the meantime, we're losing our language. And so we see material that's available for us to use, and we have an educator that's got the background to deliver it. We're ready to move forward. Ready to move forward, so we present the material that's available. We also have a way of assessment to see what our kids are moving forward. And we're proposing to use the material for them to speak. To speak in them. Later time, you know that we have our policy for our language written. We're only coming with you to use the material so our children can speak and it's all. Everything's done. But I just want to show you also, right from speaking, and show you some of the assessments that are available to you. It's always great and nice to
Anyway, well, how may I here? And John will repeat this. So, they traveled from Pennsylvania. Anyway, later, when they did develop the curriculum, I have attended City School College for the past 3 summers, and I took a lot of courses, taught my own as well, but also a course with Ben Black Bear Jr., who unfortunately couldn't make it tonight. He's co-author of the grammar book right there. I did have training in methods for all the curriculum here. And at St. Joe's, they were the first, when they first got, really worked hard. And then we were able to get that jump up. And I was really excited in this position.
Communicative language.
materials are alike, and you know, they form a template for a lot of other languages and then to try to achieve as well.
As a retired educator, I've always had issues with canned curriculums and people coming in and bringing us in programs. I highly respect Cindy Young, but she is not a Lakota speaker. And my question to you, Sage, did you talk to the Lakota Studies people out of the college and get their opinion on this?
I just wish you would have
talk to the Coast Guard Department for local language teachers out there to get their opinion on this. We also have a lot of highly respected elderly Native American educators that I think you could contact. Donnie Lebold, who I know is against this, Lydia Wilkins, there's a lot of people I think that you could have reached out to get their opinion. I can't honestly say that I would support something like this without getting opinion from some of our elderlies at the college and some of our Native American elder educators.
Say, Jay, do you have something to say? I know that you have already started. My mother, Charlotte, was a Lakota speaker, and she has just commented on Alex, who is at your school, coming home and how much Lakota she's learned in the proper pronunciation, whereas her own children can't speak it. Now her grandchildren are learning it, and she has one at UDOM too. So I just want to say that whatever you're doing a good job, because my mother, who is fluent in Lakota and the traditional Lakota, has said that Alex's skills are amazing to them. Thank you for that.
I just want to applaud your efforts. Same to having been at the traditional schools. And then also, are you asking for the whole district level to use this, or just the local schools?
So then my last question would be, would you use LLC exclusively, or would you be open to using others as well?
I would use just how I managed it, use all of my titles. We could use there's a number of photographers out there, but like what me and Cindy talked about, but it's not about photographers and it's about, again, it's about how well are you. How well can you deliver that language so that you're able to make
Somebody said that we developed the curriculum of two of us. It's actually not precisely the case. As a linguist, I worked with over 400 native speakers, elders, to develop the dictionary and the grammar and the curriculum. So it's not just my work, it's the others' work. It's their input, it's their sentences, it's their stories that they said. All of those things are in those books. They're not my sentences. They're sentences that come from the elders. So that's one thing I'd like to say. And excuse my accent, I'm self-aware of English. And the other thing I'd like to say is, you have to ask yourself one question. The Lakota language has been taught in Lakota, on Lakota reservation in school for over 4 decades. So, if you have 4 decades of Lakota instructions, where are all the young people who are graduates from the schools over 4 decades who are fluent in Lakota? Where are they? They don't exist. Now, if you happen to go to Finland, Norway, Germany, France, China, children go to school and learn a second language or 2 second languages, and many of them are fluent in those languages, in their second languages, without speaking those second languages in their homes, just learning them at school. So why is it possible in Finland or Germany, and why not here? And the simple answer to that is that in Finland and Germany and China, they're using effective language teaching methods, standards, standard orthography, and good communicative teaching methods, they have quality teacher training. So if all these things are in place for Lakota, it's going to work for Lakota as well, because it's worked for many languages around the world. And being able to speak a second language is not an end goal in its own self. It has multiple benefits in the students' academic achievements and in their mental development and so on and so on. So, you know, you can either continue to do what has been done for 40 years, or you can try something new. That's up to you. Thank you for listening.
Okay, we have a motion and a second.
Chair.
Yes, sir.
I guess my comment on the question that's being presented tonight, I am kind of like not had the opportunity to look at, but even if I had, I still wouldn't have the good proper questions. So what I guess I'm looking from the outside, I'm looking at saying, maybe this is something that we can start out and continue on doing what you're doing now, say, like continuing on. But I've heard the expression of a concern of adopting something, you know, adopting a curriculum totally based off other opinions and something. I'm offering to say, I'd be willing to look at, let's be doing this, but in the meantime, we're having an opportunity to study the other side of it, but give you the direction, let's go with what you're doing now and keep on going until we make the decision if this is totally whatever curriculum and stuff that we want to use. That's me looking as not real knowledgeable of the subject matter. I hate to say I'm supporting something I totally don't know even what it's about. So that's my opinion. Maybe like the board did kind of consider what I said about let's go with this, but that's kind of all I got to say about that.
Okay, I guess I'll be last then. I understand that there are questions about it. However, I do feel like adopt something and we can always supplement it with other things because that's what you do in the classroom. So I'm going to go ahead and call for a vote if there are no other comments. All in favor of adopting this curriculum?
Yes.
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 we'll go with it. Thank you for your presentation.
Thank you, and I'm just going to add, we have adult language classes for free on Sundays through this curriculum that Ellen teaches, because we're not sharing it with our kids, we're sharing it with our community, because we want to raise speakers. Sage is very passionate about it, I'm very passionate about it, and so is our whole team, our staff, this is this curriculum. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, next up on our agenda is the superintendent's report.
Eventually, this is going to get torn down, is my assumption right now. So totally the space for the equipment in the high school. And also, when we put the school light out, by bringing it further to the east, what we do is we present it right to the parking lot so that it's not, a long walk to get to, and it allows us to bring the aesthetics out closer to where you can see it coming from the school. We're sort of hiding the existing gym, which is a
what?
It's a marvelous engineering. It's just a standard kind of building. And our plans are going to show from high-end as much as we can to make that with a little more kind of standing up right now. And so we're going to cover that with some triangle or something along those lines to make it a little more presentable.
The elevations of the building itself.
east elevation, the east facing elevation, which is where our entrance is. This is our addition right here, and then this is the existing gymnasium in the background behind it. We're still working on yoga to the end, but we've got some three-dimensional drawings of this. We're still working on the action of the materials we're going to go here. We originally did tilt up, that's a possibility. We may go with a concrete block, but not just a plain concrete block. It's called, there's a thing called a burnish block, or a concrete block. They break it in half, it gives a nice texture, makes it look like snow. And then we intersperse in that polished concrete block, so that looks almost like marble. So we're taking a fairly simple material and we elevate it to another level. And by using it in different layers, we create a texture and a bit of a up here right now, we're showing the metal cladding. One idea we've gotten is just in the spirit of the creek next door, put a wavy sort of effect on the metal where it sort of creates a wave and intersperses with the layer below it. We'll have more details of that as we go on. And again, as we go through the design phase, I'll be presenting, giving them the information in chat and we'll take for approval. We'll have several versions of some of these design issues. It's not going to affect the actual layout of the building itself. But we're just trying to get an aesthetically pleasing building that the community is going to be proud of and enjoy having. This is a detail of the wall section. We're still working on this. We're going to have a few more to populate this page as we get done. We're still, unfortunately, waiting for the soils report, so this is just a temporary placeholder basically for the foundation itself. It's probably what it's going to wind up being, but we can't commit to it yet until we finally get that soils report. And they have been here, right?
So,
some more interior elevations, and this is just the hallway that we talked about with the lockers on the side. And then this is the front of the classroom where you have the display boards and things like that. And we'll coordinate as far as the actual layout, the final layout of these with the teachers or desires to have input on this, but it's just to kind of show you how this is going to look. We can tweak this to whatever works best for the system that's going to be in place here. All right, and now I've got some 3D elevations just to give you a little bit better idea. There's one of them that's looking from. That's basically looking from your parking lot. This is the main entrance. We're looking from the east a little bit to the north. There's the emergency exit there. Windows for the classroom, and then here's what I was talking about. This would be that block area with the lighter. These aren't the final colors, but these are just the colors that it's from. Tweak those and coordinate those again with the school. What we're envisioning is this is that split block that we talked about. It's a little bit more like stone, and then that smooth, polished block with a little bit more granite would be these bands here. Give the school a little visual interest. Easterly looking here, and a little higher up, there's the gym again, and the main entrance as well. Same basic thing, just a slightly different angle. You can see a little bit more of the roof, we've got a flat roof. flat roofs aren't really flat, I mean, it's just in shape, so it does drain to certain spots, and then it shouldn't have any problems. Some people don't like them because they think that they could actually kind of have a better performance record over time. We can't say exactly for sure the final package of membership, but solid support. We're probably 6-ish weeks of design details, with all the design and the specifications. We're shooting for spring. I'm thinking March 1st construction start. By the time we have the design and the bid process, we don't, we're going to have to run into Christmas at some point, and so we'll want to have bids open 20th of December or so.
What are you looking at?
We can write the specs any day you want. It's just how much you want to pay.
Yeah.
This should be an 8 to 12 month project. Okay. 8 months would be more expensive, 12 months would be the cheapest. I don't think 10 months is out of line. I think you could get a pretty good price for it. So I think if we had it on March 1st, we'd finish by the end of the year. Having said that,
there's delayed weather.
That's the intention. So for the start of the second semester, we're going to be able to do it.
Okay. Thank you.
I got a different question. The entrance and the exit, nobody said anything about is when we turn around. When you come in, you turn around and back out. Is there an exit separate from the entrance?
And then I have a question on
Yeah. One, two.
Okay. Anything else?
That's the only two.
Anybody else have anything to pull out?
No.
Okay. Is there a motion to accept the consent agenda? Will out, and the other special meeting. Moved by Melissa.
I'll second.
Seconded by Laverne. All in favor?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Do you want to address?
Well, I'll make the motion so we can come up with a discussion.
I'll second.
Okay, motion by Melissa, seconded by Laverne to have discussion around the October 18th special meeting.
Okay, I'm trying to locate it here. The question I have, I wasn't present, so I'm by reading the minutes of the meeting. Could we have listed like TCA representatives or something like that? But that was just the question I had. I'm abstaining anyway. Violation. my question and thoughts on that. But once again, in January,
He's not available
without a contract. Once he signs it, I guess, or once we enter into it. But I'm just reiterating that if he doesn't follow through, that that's our consequences. That's our call. That's the question I have.
Okay. Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay. Motion by Smithers, seconded by Melissa. Those in favor?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you.